We get more rumors of the iPhone 6 and its screen size and launch date. Other Galaxy S5 rumors go in detail on the iris scanner. And if you want an LG G Flex on AT&T, your wait is now over. I'm Jaime Rivera, and the faster I record and edit this video, the faster Monday will be over. You know I hate that thing. This is Pocket Now Daily. Let us begin today with some official news, as AT&T has just decided to follow on Sprint's footsteps. They're now launching the LG G Flex pre-orders for now, and you can pay the same premium, $300, after a two-year contract for the phone. But the biggest issue is that at least on Sprint, you know when you're getting your phone, which the problem is AT&T is not providing any dates. But again, if you want the LG G Flex on AT&T, this is the only way to get it for now. And speaking of AT&T, let's talk about HTC, as more credible sources kind of confirm that we are getting an HTC One Plus, or whatever they're going to call the M8, which is the code name, in AT&T. We are expecting for this phone to be announced very soon. And yes, AT&T is going to be one of the carriers that's going to be using it. We're just hoping that they don't make it another exclusive like what happened with the One initially. But yeah, we are expecting it for AT&T. We get details on the fact that it's going to have a bigger display and that it will be running KitKat out of the box. So stay tuned for that. And for those of you waiting for more details on the Sony Xperia Z2, we get more details on its specifications, and it's pretty much a Z1 Snapdragon 800 processor. We get almost everything. I guess the only differences are the fact that this phone is going to be launching with KitKat, and the fact that for those of you that were waiting for a 2K display on this Z2, you're going to have to wait. It's pretty much going to be the same Z1. We just don't know any specifics on design just yet, except for the fact that apparently the back is not going to be made of glass, but let's see what we get in the end. We're just expecting this to be a US carrier variant, but MWC will probably tell. Now let's talk about Samsung and the Galaxy S5. We get two leaks that are very interesting. First of all, we get another screenshot of the magazine UI for the Galaxy S5, which is great. We did love that at CES for the whole tablet ecosystem. But aside from that, we get more details on the specifications on this phone. First of all, apparently we are getting a 20 megapixel camera like on the Sony phones, and not really the 16 megapixel ISO cell camera that we've been hearing for years already. So that's one thing that's baked. Another thing is that apparently we are definitely getting a 2K display, aside from a 2900 milliamp hour battery, etc. Let's just hope that they figure out better build quality on this phone, but stay tuned for that. And finally, for the very interesting news of the day, we get more details on the iPhone 6, or should we say iPhone 6s, as apparently we are getting two phones again. And this time we're not talking about the whole iPhone 5C, iPhone 5S thing. Apparently we are getting a 4.7 inch iPhone 6, which sounds interesting until you start hearing about the fact that it's gonna keep the same resolution as the current iPhone 5S. So I don't know how Apple's planning to sell us the fact that that is still a Retina display, but even more interesting is the fact that apparently we're getting a 5.7 inch phablet from Apple, and we're still wondering exactly what they're planning to do with that phablet. So that leads me to the question of the day. Are you interested in a phablet from Apple? Is that something that you're waiting for? Because in my particular case, after the disappointment of the original iPad mini, I'm not sure that I really want this phablet. I mean, Samsung already owns Wacom. What are they planning to do for the stylus and everything? What are they planning to make this thing different or unique? Leave us a comment down below. What do you think? And friends, you know the drill. If you want to get the news earlier before this video was filmed, make sure you follow us on PocketNow.com and subscribe to our YouTube channel as well. You can also follow me on Twitter, Jaime_Rivera. Please give this video a thumbs up if you like what you saw. I am Jaime Rivera. Thank you very much for watching. We will see you tomorrow.